So welcome back to the channel. In this video, I'm going to explain the Nomad Bridge hack, which occurred today, and also go into the kind of contagion effects as it pertains to Moonbeam primarily here, as this is a cryptocurrency I'm actually interested in. So we're going to go through the details here. This was an exploit of quite epic proportions, and on top of that, it included just loads of random people getting involved. It wasn't one hacker. Lots of people were able to essentially copy-paste their way into this and potentially run away with a load of funds. But depending on how big your balls are, you know, maybe you want to return those funds once you've had a few sleepless nights. So I think some of these funds will trickle back under the white hat kind of initiative here. But this was essentially a really cool visualization of what happened here. Initial exploiter goes in and then the bandwagon arrives afterwards. So just a quick breakdown in this thread here. We're not going to go into the technicals as that is not my forte, but this is from OxFubar. Earlier in the day, Sam CZ Sun over on Twitter actually put forward, you know, exactly how this is done in terms of the code behind it and what was the incorrect piece of code that allowed for this attack to take place. But what we're seeing here is the first decentralized crowd looting of a nine-figure bridge in history, as he so eloquently posts here. So from $190 million and then a few hours later down to $1,800 in TVL for the Nomad Bridge here. So this wasn't a bridge that I had used or was particularly familiar with, but it's quite an interesting one, as this one recently got a load of funding. So after initial attack struck, hundreds of separate accounts figured out the trick, copy-pastering their way into grabbing stolen funds, TVL falling off a cliff here. Then what we're seeing here on Twitter is quite a few individuals actually just started to run the hack process, as they knew what to do, just to obviously take those funds. Because, you know, if you've got the ability to do this and you can take $1 million off the table, that those $1 million belong to people and they're going to be hurt by this. So if you can then return them when the coast is clear later, then that is a pretty good deed in my book. So there's a few examples of guys on screen who did that exactly. So a perplexing aspect of the vulnerability was that all users had to do was hack the bridge by copying the original hacker's transaction call data, replacing the original address, i.e. the hacker's address, with their personal one, and then the transaction would succeed. You could get like a 0.1 wrapped BTC transaction sent in, and then on the flip side you could get 100 wrapped BTC out. So that was one of the copy pastas there, which is just insane to think about. So a load of funds have been absolutely ravaged from this bridge. This goes into the process, the Merkle routes, etc. But not a happy day's hunting here. So essentially, the fact that there was some code that was incorrect means that every message gets auto-approved by default, which is the opposite of what nullifying a Merkle route typically means. So once MEV replacement bots ran simulations on address replacements in the call data, the copypasta skills sent funds flying in all directions. The TLDR here, a poor operational strategy led to bad Merkle route initialization, which led to every message being proven valid by default. So this was going on this morning. There was just loads of transactions being posted onto Twitter, like hundreds of thousands of USDC just being withdrawn, and you can see a load of ETH as well going through Tornado Cash. So some people have made off like bandits here. This just comes a few months after nomad.xyz got this kind of funding round, $22 million of seed round investment from Polychain and a few other big names in here, like sort of Circle Group and angel investors from the likes of Polkadot and more down there as well. So rather interesting stuff. This is the actual website here, app.nomad.xyz. And the chains you could bridge between were ETH, AVAX, EVMOS, Milkameda, and Moonbeam. Okay, so Moonbeam is the primary focus for this video. All the assets that were hacked were done so on the Ethereum side of things. There was the Ethereum smart contract that was hacked. But of course, on the one side, you have these assets on ETH, and then you're going to get them bridged over to these other chains, but then under the MAD prefix. So they were like MAD USDC would have been the name. If you go and check out MAD USDC on CoinGecko, you will see it's trading at just 11 cents now, i.e. a load of people have lost 90% on those dollars, but essentially they are actually worthless due to the fact there is no collateral back on the original chain there. So a load of assets in these various chains now are worth zero. And this is going to have a load of various nasty effects, because imagine you're in an LP position with, say, MAD USDC versus another stablecoin. Well, this has totally screwed over the whole of that LP position for everybody. There's going to be cascading issues around this. So this is going to be a severe headache for all teams involved with this one. Thank God it was just the five chains involved here, but still going to be tons and tons of work. $190 million plus worth of capital, you know, with bad debt out there, essentially. So not good whatsoever. So as Paradigm Engineer posted here, if you have any funds in any of these chains, so Nomad.xyz, EVMOS, Moonbeam, or Milkamada, you need to swap out of the Nomad assets, which have the MAD prefix, and use a different bridge to bridge them back to ETH or another chain ASAP. So there will be a lot of losers in this scenario, unfortunately. And he says that Nomad has been chosen as the canonical bridge for EVMOS, Moonbeam, and Milkamada. So you need to get all of your assets off these chains immediately, he says. That might be a little bit of an overreach, but there is going to be issues for all of these chains when you've got assets now on your chain that have no value because there's no collateral backing them up. It's going to be a real, real ball ache here. So if we just look at the Moonbeam projects here, the likes of Stellarswap, this is obviously a DeFi project on here, down 36% over 24 hours. BeamSwap, 27% down. Solflare, 27% down. And then Moonbeam token itself, down 16%, was as low as like 22-25% earlier, pushing towards the actual all-time lows here as well, interestingly enough. So this one went as low as 64 cents earlier. I think on a wick it was down to 60, but after a few days of, you know, really ticking up here, it's had a heck of a crash here. So not very good for Moonbeam, the Glimmer token, and its wider DeFi applications. There's going to be a load of headaches around this in terms of sorting this out. Are they going to reimburse users via maybe some team funds, or are those users just going to be out of pocket due to this bridge hack, which they probably had no real ideas around, you know, how badly affected they could be from this? It's a very unfortunate situation. And now this brings up two issues really here. One is that Moonbeam have directly addressed this situation here on Twitter, and they talk about this security incident here affecting one of the Moonbeam bridges. But nearly all of the assets in Nomad's ETH mainnet smart contract were drained. We have found no evidence that the recent security incident was related to the Moonbeam code base. So they were checking their own code base. That is not where the issue lied. So that is obviously a positive. But they haven't gone on to mention what's going to happen with these assets that now have no backing back on ETH, you know, because you've got those assets on your chain and now essentially they are worthless. There's been nothing around that as of yet. So I would like them to come out with a statement as to what they're going to do to try and rectify this or patch this up, as this does negatively impact those DeFi apps and the individuals with those tokens. On top of this as well, they had to stop the network. So a lot of people were saying, you know, how can you have a decentralized chain here, something they want to, you know, really rival the likes of Ethereum, but you just turned it off. It went into a maintenance and you couldn't really do anything for a while, for at least, I think, 6, 7, 8 hours as they were checking things out in the background. You know, that is not very decentralized. And on top of this as well, there was also this Monday, 27th of June, Moonriver and Moonbeam both received updates through runtime 1606 to resolve a security issue that was responsibly disclosed by an independent white hat hacker. So there's been some other security breaches on there as well, but of course that one looks like it was resolved internally and a bounty being given out. But nonetheless, not very good here for Moonbeam and very bad PR overall. And the fact that that is their canonical bridge means that there's probably quite a lot of funds here that are going to be affected. And this needs to be a real lesson learned here, that they're going to have to shore up the way that they are bridging funds in. I know most bridges have been hacked at this point, which is pretty bad, but maybe only using the most secure, or maybe not even allowing new bridges to be set up, because, you know, obviously you can't have these things happening all of the time. Vitalik posted about this previously, that multi-chain is going to be a problem due to the fact there's so many vulnerability in bridges. And some of the bridge attacks as well have been confirmed as North Korean hackers. So when you've got the North Korean government actually trying to ensure that crypto bridges and other sites, etc., are hacked just so they can drain funds, well, you know these things are going to continue to happen. So this is something that is obviously very concerning for the industry. Chainlink God posted this: not only are the people who held Nomad bridged tokens now completely wrecked, but so are the chains that use Nomad as the canonical token bridge. The contagion effects are real and absolutely brutal. So he's also very worried about the contagion effects here that may take days, weeks to actually filter through the system here, as there's going to be a load of tokens that just have a zero value. You can't redeem them. What do you do with them? As I've mentioned, is there going to be someone stepping in and trying to make these tokens whole again somehow? We don't really know. It's very early to actually call this one right now, but this is very, very negative. And when you can see that some of the smartest minds in the space, like Chainlink God here, is very worried about this contagion effects, well, I think it's worth having on your radar that utilizing some of the DeFi apps on these networks right now, probably not the best idea. And if you can get your funds off, probably would do so. And I think this will open up a massive opportunity for Glimmer token here to go lower. The yellow line on the screen at 55 cents is the all-time low thus far. We've touched it twice. We came close earlier down to around 60 cents on a wick. So from 67 cents down to 55 cents, we're going to visit that pretty damn soon and maybe break even lower again as we see these contagion effects roll out. And so what I want to see is a very stellar response from the Moonbeam team going forward as to how they're going to rectify this, how they're going to ensure these kind of hacks don't occur in the future, and what are they going to do to safeguard users' funds. If we get some positive answers, I'm definitely looking to accumulate Glimmer still, but if I don't see the kind of good answers that I want to, this does and this can put me off actually investing into this token, although I do see there being a good risk to reward play here in the not too distant future. But in terms of the emissions, you know, this token is inflationary, and with all the unlocks coming to parachain holders, especially after a negative bit of sentiment like this in the market, you know that a lot of these tokens are going to continue getting dumped. So I'm keeping my eyes open for prices sub 50 cents at this point. And if we get any nasty moves lower than that, you know, I'm probably going to scoop up a load of these tokens. Many people were predicting we could see maybe a $50 Moonbeam token, the Glimmer token, during the next cycle. But that seems like a long way off at this point. So just some things that I'm looking at here. Interested in this one still, but you know, today's effects are going to take some time to really work their way through here. So we shall stay tuned and see what happens. If you enjoyed this one, please subscribe to the channel. If you're new and you've subscribed, drop me a comment down below, say hello, and I will see you in the next one. Goodbye.